In next concept, we are going to describe the how can we represent the vector in three-dimensional representation and two-dimensional representation. To represent a vector, we required some Cartesian coordinate system. Cartesian coordinate system means, if it is a two-dimensional coordinate system means, that is x comma y coordinate system, and if it is a three-dimensional coordinate system means, it is a x, y, z coordinate system. Now, first of all, we are going to describe the vector in three-dimensional Cartesian coordinate system, representation of a vector in three-dimensional coordinate system. Suppose, if I consider the vector here, one vector is there here, that vector is having the origin at this point, this is the position vector a bar, this vector is a bar, and this vector is from the origin, it will be started at point O and ending at point C. Along x axis, along y axis and along z axis, I am going to consider the different directions, that means along with respect to three dimensional space, we are going to represent the ball, represented like this. Now, in three dimensional coordinate system, the vector will be represented as, before going to the represent a vector, I am going to consider the unit vectors along x axis, along y axis and along z axis. And if I consider I j, I cap comma j cap and k cap are the unit vectors acting along x, y and z axis respectively. I, j, k are the unit vectors acting along the x, y, z axis respectively. I, j, k are the unit vectors means unit vectors gives the direction of direction of the particle at that vector. Now, suppose to represent the position vector of that vector, position vector is nothing but a bar. A bar is equal to along x I cap plus y j cap plus z k cap, x I cap, y j cap and z cap. Along the x axis, it is having a distance x, and along the y axis, it is having a distance y. Along the z axis, it is having a distance z k. Now, to represent the three-dimensional representation, OC bar is equal to OA bar plus OB bar plus AB bar plus BC bar. This is the total OC bar. And in this, to represent this vector, I am going to consider the sum of the all those vectors along x axis, this is OA, and along y axis, this is AB, and along z axis, it is Z. Along the z axis, this is BC. Now, along OC, OC bar is nothing but A bar here. A bar is equal to XI, X is the distance along x axis into unit vector, Y is the distance along y axis into its unit vector, and Z is the distance along z axis with a unit vector k cap. This is the representation of a vector in three-dimensional space. Suppose I have to find out the unit vector along this vector, for this vector. Unit vector is nothing but the a cap. Unit vector is represented by a cap is equal to a bar by modulus of a bar. A bar by modulus of a bar. A bar by modulus of a bar means a bar is nothing but xi plus yj plus zk. Xi plus yj plus zk by root over, this is the modulus of a bar means here we are going to consider root over x square plus y square plus z square, x square root over x square plus y square plus z square. This is the representation of a unit vector a cap. I j k are the unit vectors along x axis, y axis and z axis. A cap is the unit vector of vector a, this is the a bar by modulus of a bar, x I plus y j plus z k by root over x square plus y square plus z square. Here, the resultant vector makes an angle with the, some angle with the x axis and as well as y axis and as well as z axis. How much angle it will be making here? Resultant vector making an angle alpha with x axis, and resultant vector making an angle beta with y axis, and resultant vector making an angle gamma with z axis. Now I am going to find out that resultant angles by the resultant vector with x axis, y axis and z axis here. Now from this diagram I am going to consider cos alpha. Cos alpha is equal to, here the angle is cos alpha this angle, and I am going to consider this vector here. Cos alpha is equal to adjacent side by hypotenuse. Adjacent side is nothing but x by a bar. A bar is this vector. Adjacent side by this vector. Now this is nothing but the x is equal to a bar cos alpha. That is equal to cos alpha, we can write as the cos alpha is equal to x by root over a bar means root over x square plus y square plus z square. X square plus y square plus z square. Now I am going to find out the cos beta value. Cos beta value means this one. Cos beta is nothing but the angle made by the resultant vector with the y axis. Resultant vector with the y axis. Cos beta is equal to y by a bar. Y by a bar. Now y is the this distance here, and a bar is the OC bar. Now that is equal to y is equal to a bar cos beta, a bar cos beta. Now how can we represent the cos beta value here? Cos beta is equal to y by modulus of a. Modulus of a means root over x square plus y square plus z square. X square plus y square plus z square. Now I am going to find out the gamma value. So gamma is nothing but the angle made by the resultant vector with y axis, z axis here. It is the z axis. Now here resultant vector making an angle gamma with z axis means gamma cos gamma is equal to, now cos gamma is equal to how much here? Z by a. That is equal to, z is equal to a bar cos gamma. Now here cos gamma is equal to z by root over x square plus y square plus z square. X square plus y square plus z square. This is the, here this is equation number 1 and this is equation number 2 and this is equation number 3 and this is equation number 4 here, and this equation number is 5 and this is equation number 6. Now see, suppose if we consider the equation number 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 5, 1, if we consider 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, if the these equations are represented, the x values are nothing but the x comma y comma z are called as directional ratios. And cos alpha, cos beta and cos gamma are called as directional cosines. Cos alpha, cos beta and cos gamma are called as directional cosines. X comma y comma z are called as directional ratios. Here the angle made by the resultant vector with x axis is cos alpha. Cos alpha is equal to x by root over x square plus y square plus y z square, and cos beta is equal to y by root over x square plus y square plus z square, and cos gamma is equal to z by root over x square plus y square plus z square. These are the cos alpha, cos beta and cos gamma represents the directional cosines. X comma y comma z represents the directional ratios. Suppose I have to find out the, in terms of directional cosines I have to write the xi plus yj plus zk. Now x is nothing but the a bar cos alpha into I cap plus a bar sin alpha into j cap plus a bar sin gamma into k cap. This is a representation of a vector with respect to the directional cosines. A bar is equal to a bar into cos alpha into I, a bar into sin alpha into j, a bar into sin gamma into k. This is a three dimensional representation of a vector. A vector can be represented in three dimensional with respect to the x, y, z axis by considering the I, j, k unit vectors along x axis, y axis and z axis. Now here cos alpha, cos beta, cos gamma are called as directional cosines, and directional ratios x comma y comma z are called as directional ratios. Okay. Next concept, representation of a vector in two dimensional space.